Hey everybody, and welcome to part one of this game creation series. In the last video I explained this is going to be my new project, and if you want to check that out there'll be a link up here, go and click this. So as I mentioned, I'll be using the Unreal Engine to be creating this game, which I have no experience for. Hopefully by the end of it we'll have something that not only looks good but actually works. So hopefully you'll follow along this series and either watch me create something okay, or I might completely fail and you guys can learn from my mistakes. So let's go ahead and set up the project. As I mentioned in the previous video, the Unreal Engine uses what's called a blueprint system. So instead of having to know C++, we can create loads of different game mechanics using these blueprints. I'm going to choose a preset. Now the game is going to be first person, but for the presets I'm going to choose third person. I'm going to be creating this for the desktop with maximum quality and using the starter content. Let's go ahead and rename this. So this is the abbreviation of the game title, and let's create the project. So I should also note that these videos are not tutorials. I won't really be teaching anything. I'm just going to show you the process of how I'm doing things. Hopefully you can learn from the mistakes. I'm still learning it myself, so if you guys have any suggestions or tips, then go ahead and throw in the comments below. But I will explain the things as I do it, just for anybody who's not used to the Unreal Engine can sort of get an idea how it works as well. So the game itself I want to create is an adventure puzzle game. So something like MYST, if you guys have seen this game. So I played this game a long time ago. It's probably one of the first PC games that I played. It was such a cool game because it was pretty well made at the time. The graphics were really good. The puzzles were really interesting and the story was just, it was very interesting. I enjoyed it. So that's going to be the core of the game. So a story-driven adventure puzzle game, I guess. Then for the design, I kind of want to go with something that looks like Bioshock. If anyone's played this game, it's really such an amazing franchise, I guess. I mean, obviously I'm not going to get anywhere near to as good a game as this, but, you know, just the aesthetics, the sort of old-timey yet futuristic, maybe otherworldly type thing. But I think the graphics just look really, really good, so I kind of want to go for something like that. It's not a horror or action game, but that's the sort of aesthetic that I want to reach. So with that in mind, I planned out a story that I want to tell. I wrote down some things that I want to add to the game, which I hope will make it interesting. So there's quite a few things on this list that I kind of want to achieve. And it all starts here, I guess, in this first video. And the first thing I want to do is change the third person camera to be first person. And then in future videos, we're just going to keep adding to it and changing the environment and so on and so forth. So let's go ahead and get started. For those who haven't used Unreal before, I'm just going to quickly explain what we're looking at. We first have the viewport where we can add things to and build up our level. We have our character here and a few other objects. Then over here we have the world outliner, which is essentially a hierarchy of all the objects in the scene. Then over here we have the details panel, so if we have something selected, we can change a whole bunch of details. Then down here we have the content browser. Now this content browser will be full of blueprints and other assets that we add to it as the game goes on. We can also add a whole bunch of stuff here as well. So essentially that's what we're looking at. And I will link to some tutorials on the basics of the user interface. If you guys are stuck, go ahead and check the description. In this video, I want to change the camera to be first person. So the way we do that, we need to go to blueprints and go to your character. For me, it's called third person character. But if you chose a different preset when you started your project, it'll be called something else. So go ahead and open that up. So we have this window here. Let's go ahead and maximize it. So straight away, we're in the event graph. And as I mentioned in the previous video, it looks a lot like Blender's compositor. That's what makes me feel more comfortable about using this. If it was all lines of code, it'd just be overwhelming and I'm not sure if I'd be able to make a game. But with this, it actually feels possible. So the event graph will definitely play a big part later on. But for right now, I just want to change this from the event graph tab to the viewport. Now we can see our character. And again, for right now, I'm going to use this mannequin example. In the future, I will be replacing it with a character, but for now, I'm just going to use this as a placeholder. And I'm going to do that for quite a few things. I'm just going to add placeholder objects, then build the functionality, and then come back and change it for the objects that I want. So let's go ahead and change this camera. So over here in the components tab, let's go down to the follow camera. I'm going to left click and drag this on top of the mesh. So it's now been parented to this mesh. Then we can drag it over. Position this. So we want the camera to move with the motion of the character. So over here where it says sockets, I'm going to click this socket pin. And then I want to go down and find a socket to pin this to. And then right here we have the head. So as soon as we do that, it moves the camera out of the way and it also rotates it. So I'm just going to reposition this over here. Something like that. I'm also going to rotate this. Maybe, is it 90? That's the wrong way, so I'm going to delete that. Minus 90. There we go. So now the camera is facing the correct way. We can also reposition it just a bit. Then we just need to do a couple more things. Just drag this out. So down here under camera options, we want to make sure that the use pawn control rotation is checked. Then if we go back up here, select the third person character self. Then down under pawn, use controller rotation yaw. Just check this, and there we go. If we didn't enable these options, the camera would be able to turn and look at the character's face, which would not look right. So that's why we need to check those options. So now we have this, we need to make sure we compile. It's always important to compile it. You can also save it if you want to as well. Then close this down, press play, and just check it out. So that looks good, and it all works fine. So it was really easy to change the camera's perspective. Maybe in the future we'll add an option where the player can choose between first person and third person. Maybe we'll do that. But for now, I'm happy with this being a first person camera. In the next video, we're going to be adding a flashlight. We're also going to be adding a battery to that flashlight so it can drain. Then when the battery runs out, the flashlight will turn off. And we can also add a refill pickup. So it's quite a few things to do in the next one, but I think it's important to add a flashlight for our character. So I hope to see you in the next video, and thanks for watching.